I suppose I was a critic from my very first years. I used to go and leave the cinema with very firm opinions about what the film was like, but I didn't in those days, as a small boy, have the privilege of being able to voice them publicly. But I became, if you like, a professional critic for the first time when I was still a teenager. I wrote a review off my own bat for a publication which had only just started up called Voice. It was founded by Harold Levine, one of the bright intellectual sparks in Sydney, and I came into Harold's office one day and volunteered this review I'd written of a Swedish film called One Summer of Happiness, which I think was banned for a while or severely cut in Australia. In any event, I did a review and I was delighted when it was published. After that, when I was on the Sydney Morning Herald in the late 60s, early 70s, I reviewed films for the Herald. Then after I left the Herald, I briefly reviewed films for the first issues of Australian Playboy, a magazine launched in Sydney in the 1980s and edited by Mark Day, who gave me plenty of space. But my big opportunity came when I was invited by Maria Perau, the arts editor of The Australian, in 1981 to succeed Geraldine Pascall as film critic of The Australian. And I've been doing that now for 33 years until I relinquished that position last December. In my time, I've been not only a film critic, I've been a journalist in different fields. I've been a feature writer and a leader writer, and I've been a speechwriter for different politicians. I've been a bureaucrat, or what we rather grandly call an arts administrator. And I've had a good time. I'm one of those old-fashioned people who tend to believe that the internet and the digital age has done rather more harm than good, but history may well prove me wrong on that score. I think what has happened is that now that anyone can post their opinions and record their views on their website or in cyberspace, we have a vast proliferation of opinions. Whether that means we have a better selection of critical writing or film criticism from which to choose, I think, is another matter. There's much more to read, though. I think, on the whole, the more opinions that are expressed, the better. And that's certainly what we're getting in this digital age. I still prefer myself to read things in print. I'm an old-fashioned, unreconstructed print journalist. The cinema is all part of a global entertainment network, and films are much the same everywhere. And I think with the influence of Hollywood is now pervasive that films from every country tend to have a lot more in common than they used to. But it's, I think, very important to preserve and celebrate the distinctive character of Australian filmmaking. And I think it's part of our culture. I think critics and filmmakers have to be aware that Australian audiences want Australian stories told with their own Australian cast and in their own Australian settings, and we must preserve this. Our critics on the whole are very good. I have the greatest respect for many of them. I mean, we can all be a bit too academic at times or a bit too didactic, but in general, I think the standards of criticism in this country are very high, and we're lucky to have such people as Paul Burns and Sandra Hall and David Stratton, Craig Matheson and many others who would stand out in any company. I think my advice would be try your hand at it. Keep writing and keep practicing. Read the best film criticism that's available and take some inspiration from it. We're all reviewing the same films, except that Australian critics, of course, have to be aware of the Australian film industry and what it uniquely offers to Australian audiences. And that means we bring a somewhat different perspective to our views of Australian films. We perhaps tend to be a little more sympathetic than we would be if they were coming from Hollywood or somewhere else. But I think that's important. The Australian film industry, after all, is a very old one. The very first feature film in the world was made in Australia. And we have a very well-established, internationally respected industry. And these days, of course, many of our best actors and stars and writers and directors and cinematographers have made reputations for themselves on the international film scene. And I don't think we've ever enjoyed such universal recognition as we do now.
Well, I think critics always regarded with a certain amount of suspicion, and that's probably a healthy thing. I think also a certain amount of envy comes into it. I'm often asked by my friends, or I was when I was reviewing full time, do you mean to say you get paid for going to films and writing about them? And they think it's the best job in the world. I have to point out sometimes that constantly writing about films and meeting newspaper or other deadlines can be quite a stressful and hazardous existence. And we're not the highest paid practitioners in the world, but I think all of us enjoy what we do.